Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Rosie and I hope you guys are doing fine. So as you can tell from the title of the video, I'm going to be giving you tips on vision board, and this is my vision board right here on the back. This is my bedroom and this is something that I get requested often on my Instagram, on my past videos about the same topic, that video that's become really popular about my law of attraction stories. And you guys seem to really like it. And lately I have been seeing 1111 so many times and the number 222, which that one is new to me actually, but 1111, I see it so often for a while. It was not happening, but now it's coming back again. So some people say it's signs from the angels. Some people say that good things are coming to you, or if you see it, just make a wish. I decide to believe on everything. I believe good things are coming, especially now that we're ending the year and a new year is coming. I think a vision board, it's a great project for this new coming year. So I invite you guys to subscribe to my channel and to follow me on my social media pages. I'm everywhere with the same name, Lynn Sire. And without talking anymore, let's begin. So first step would be to plan it out. So what do you want to add to that vision board? What do you want to see? So for me, at least, I knew I wanted to add three things, and from those three things, I knew were the main things, and then the other items were just extras. So you can start thinking about if you're going to add photos, what quotes, or your own phrases. That's what I did. So first step, it's just to plan it out. What do you guys want to see on your vision board and make a list? So the next step would be, how big do you need your vision board to be? So in one of my most popular videos, my board was so big. Now that I see it, I think that is way too big. And so now I knew I wanted something small and simple. And that's what I applied to all the areas of my life where I make my life so simple. Something small, like the one that I had here. And this is something you can get for so cheap at Dollar Tree. They have these available. I didn't have a Dollar Tree nearby, so I got it at Office Depot, but now I have a Dollar Tree that is close to me. So the next step would be to start looking for those images. So before, what I used to do, I would look for everything on magazines, but I found that if I did that, it would get me out of focus, and then I would see things that I didn't plan out to add. So what I do now to make it more simple for myself, I just get on Google if there's a specific card that I have in mind. I think it's so much easier that way. And all the images that I start finding, I will put it in a folder in my laptop. Okay, so once I have all the images in that folder, I'm ready to print it out. I know both Windows and Mac, but I never get used to Mac. I'm more of a Windows person. So once I have that ready, I select all the photos and I right click and I hit print. From this, I kind of know the images have to be 4x6 because the images have to be kind of small for all of them to fit on the board. That way, four images are on one paper. And then I like to select the best quality and then matte paper. I just want my images to be vibrant, and I feel like that's just much easier to see and to visualize so much better. And really important, uncheck the bottom option where it's just going to trim the edges of your images. This way, your images will come out complete. And the gray areas, don't worry about that. It won't be gray, it's just a preview. It's all going to be on a white background. Okay, so once you have all the images, then what I like to do, I use a paper cutter instead of scissor. I just think it's better, it saves time, and all the cuts come out clean. And I've had this cutter since I was a teenager, and it's something that you can get so cheap at Office Depot, on Amazon. And so this, just for me at least, it's the best way to cut any images or paper. And then the type of tape, that you use. I think it's also important. I personally don't like to use glue because I like to every now and then switch up something, and if you put glue then it's going to be hard. You would have to start all over again. So I don't use the really sticky tape, the really transparent tape, but I like to use the tape that it's kind of white, and that makes it so easy to make the image stick to the board. But then again, when you remove that image, it won't be damaging the board. And then where to put it, it all depends on you. I would put it, if I had an office space, I would put it there, but I have it here in my bedroom. I look at it before going to bed. When I wake up, it's right there in front of me. Okay, so the last step from here would be to visualize, to actually think that whatever you want to achieve, it's already part of your life. And this is, I think it's the most important step, but then I think it's the step where people really get stuck and they don't really know how to do it. And again, this is the step where you should have fun at the same time. So let's say that I have a picture on my vision board of the Eiffel Tower and that I want to go to Paris. So the first step would be to actually say it out loud. I am in Paris. So talk about like if it's actually happening right now. And then the next step would be to actually visualize, but this is the part where you kind of have to act, or just remember when you were a kid and you used to play, you had such a big imagination. So do that. So I'm gonna show you guys right now exactly how I would do it if I'm visualizing. I would close my eyes, but you don't have to close your eyes. You can do this with eyes open, but I'm letting you guys know how I've done it to attract other things in my life. This is what I would do, and this is what I would say. I'm walking down the street in France. I can hear everyone around me speaking French, and I'm walking beside a cafe with bread and coffee. I can smell the coffee and I feel the sun, the heat, the warmth on my face, and I feel the breeze. I like my dress that I'm wearing right now, and these sandals are so comfortable. That's exactly how I would do it. So as you can see, I'm using all my senses. I'm thinking about what I'm seeing, what I smell, what I feel, what I'm even wearing. So just be creative and really have fun with this step. And then just let go and believe that it's going to come to you. Don't get stuck thinking when it's going to happen, but why or when, what. Don't ask yourself all of that, just believe. So that's it, you guys. I hope this video was really helpful. Do you guys have any techniques? Are there some specific things that you guys like doing to attract something into your life? Leave it in the comment section. So if there's anything that I forgot to mention, it's going to be in the blog post, which it's going to be linked in the description box, and all the items that I mentioned, it's going to be in the description box too. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you're still not subscribed for more videos about beauty, fashion, and anything you guys want to see. Just let me know and I will make it for you guys. And you can follow me on all social media accounts. I have the same name to make it all simple. Thank you so much for watching as always, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Kisses. Bye.